G'day and welcome to episode 52 of our Let's Play of Fallout 3. My name is Turt Dalt. Let's get started. On the last episode, we decided to continue on with Mora's Wasteland Survival Guide, and instead of turning it in, I decided to go and explore that area she wanted us to go and do this quest, the Tepid Sewers. Along the way, we discovered Anchorage Memorial and recognized a little scene there on the statue from the Anchorage, Alaska DLC. Made our way in and fought through a bunch of Mire Lurks and a lot of Mire Lurk Kings, and discovered a safe that had a door control on it. Found a door that fit into, opened the door, and got a unique weapon, the tenderizer, and found a key to a stash, and found the stash and got the stash. It had some caps and a recipe for some Mire Lurk cakes, and basically that's what we did last episode. So we're gonna make our way to the Tepid Sewers, but I might drop off some mines, because I'm gonna pick up some mines here pretty quick, I think. So I might drop off 20 mines just to save some weight. So I'm gonna go via that Wilhelm's Wharf we pointed out earlier to you. And show you a way that I would take to Arlington when we... When we were searching the metros, we came across that long way to get to Arlington, and I don't ever remember taking that way to get to Arlington. I always took this way, because it's basically, you go in and then you're in Arlington, basically. I'll just show you this way. We'll be coming to Wilhelm's Wharf one day anyway to for another quest. Well, kinda, it's involved with another quest. Yeah, over there is a, you can go in there and that'll come out at the comic place. We'll go there and explore there eventually one day. Hubris Comics. This is Wilhelm's Wharf. And there's Grandma Sparkle. See if she's got anything for us today.
We got us a wanderer all the way out here in Wilhelm's Wharf. You must got some important business out here to be wandering around, but tain't none of my beeswax what you're doing. But if you're interested in trading, maybe we can help each other.
What are you doing way out here?
Right dangerous, those things. Just as soon take your head off as look at you. Watch yourself out here. They're all over.
Is there anything going on here?
Some fellas came out here a while ago that said they was looking for some do-gooder that came out from one of them vaults. I told them I ain't seen nobody like that and sent them on their way. They might still be around here, though, if you think you can help them.
Yeah, well, I think we all know who that is. I'm interested in trading.
You always need bullets. Takes damn near 100 of them to kill a guai.
And she's got nothing. And no caps. I have to go now.
Y'all come back now, you hear?
And if you search her shack, she's got nothing. You can take whatever you want. It's stealing, but she can't see ya. Right over here is a metro. See if we can get these Talon guys try our Nuka grenade. We haven't had a chance to use it yet. I don't see them. Usually they're right around here. When you talk to Grandma Sparkle, they're right there. Flooded metro. This is the one I take to go to Arlington. I don't know why you would go the other way. It's hard to find. And this goes right to Arlington, so... I should have grabbed those frag mines off the bridge first. Yeah, maybe we'll do that. And then I'll show you this little shortcut to Arlington that's a lot easier than that other way. Oh, here they are. Is this them? Six. Yeah, it is. Wow.
Hello? Who's that? I guess it was nothing.
Wow. Where'd he go? Well, I guess he won't let me do that, so I gotta go into this.
I guess it was nothing.
Yeah, there's always one guy, he's kind of the leader. He's got a high perception and a lot of health. The other two will be weak. So I couldn't pants this guy because he's got a high perception and he's in caution. And you can't pants anybody that's under caution. I don't need their armor anymore. Now these guys I'll be able to pants. I could nuke or grenade that guy just for fun. But
hello.
We'll pants him. See? No, I can walk up to them. No worries. I'll pants this guy. Yeah, I don't need their armor anymore. And we leveled up. Where'd this other guy go? Yeah, there's always one guy, he's like the leader, and three points. Yeah, boy, this is looking good, man. And we're gonna take Nerves of Steel. With Nerves of Steel perk, you regenerate action points much more quickly than you would normally.
I guess it was nothing.
Yeah, the reason I'm doing this is because the tepid sewers won't take us long. We're way above tepid sewers. We're going to be able to run through that awfully quick. So, just to fill an episode, show you this little shortcut to Arlington. Why you would go that other way, I have no idea. I'll just get you lost, as you saw. That's the way I always take to Arlington. Not hard. The other way was kind of a nightmare, especially if you're a lower level, which we were. I was way above our pay grade going that way. I saw something here. I'll just sit on the bench. And it's a completionist playthrough, so I want to show you everything. Probably getting sick of me saying completionist, but... there's a lot in this game. It's, you know, I probably won't get 100% of the game, but I'm gonna do my darndest to get it close to that. Show all the things I've discovered in my years of playing this. Oh, Ghouli. We're friends, so we don't have to do anything to him if we don't want to, but, oh, what the heck. Get some work for my machine gun. Might run into a Reaver in here, actually. Oh, nice little bench. Look at that. There you go. Hey, like, why would you go that other way? Like, that's insane. Like, why would you even attempt that? No, we'll just teleport back to... yeah, it's just something I found. I've never gone that other way to go to Arlington. That's just ridiculous to go that other way. I'll go back to Williams Wharf. There's a bunch of mines I want to pick up there. But it was fun. It was a fun adventure. I probably had been in there. I just didn't use that to get to Arlington. I just, I thought that was, surprised me when it came out at Arlington, actually. Now, normally on here, there's a bunch of mines. Where'd the mines go? That's why I came here, was to get these mines. Or is it the other bridge? No, this is the bridge. This is usually mined up. Wow, it ripped me off, guys. I don't know what to tell you. That ripped me off. Oh, well. Yeah, there's usually about 10 mines there. Well, hopefully I got enough mines. I don't need them. I like pantsing. That's all. That's my play style when I play this build. It's a pantser. Where we're going is just up ahead there. Dukov's place is right in behind. We probably won't visit that right now. We'll visit that when we're on the way to Rivet City, because I'll go this way. There's a little mini quest inside Dukov's. There's another king there. We can ignore him, actually. We don't have to kill him. Yeah, we can pick and choose our fights. We don't have to fight everything we come across anymore. Duke Ops is that building right there, but we'll do that later. There's a bunch of stuff in here, super mutants, and what is that? Actually, you know what? I might do this guy. Actually, I wonder if I can pants him. I don't think I explained the Deathclaw Gauntlet. How a Deathclaw Gauntlet works. A Deathclaw Gauntlet ignores armor. All armor. That's why it's great against the super mutants and these guys. It ignores their armor. Makes it like they're naked. That's why I like the Deathclaw Gauntlet. Look at that. More Enclave power armor. I might make a trip home. That way I can grab some mines and drop that armor off. Who's? Oh, that's that Mirelurk. That's going to make me kill him, isn't it? Well, let's do it. We're here. I want to drop that armor off. It's two kings. Well, I wonder. Probably won't, will it? Yeah. Three kings. Well, I'm going to have to do it to go home anyway. Well, lots of XP, that's for sure. Gotta make sure this guy doesn't walk into me that's walking around, that's all. Wow, I can't believe all the kings. It must be because I'm on very hard. Okay, I gotta watch this guy. Okay, good. Well, it says I can search, but it won't let me search. Okay. Okay, let's go home, drop that armor off. That's worth a lot of bullets for us, actually. I got two sets of that now. How heavy that is. And let's grab a few mines. How many mines do I have? Oh, laser rifle. 15 mines, I guess. I'll take 20. Just the weight factor. So 13 mines. Why am I so heavy? Do I have other stuff in here? A couple Mirelurk meat, that's nothing. Okay. Seemed heavy. Let's do this. Tepid sewers, here we come. Lots of mole rats. I'll be using my machine gun a bit. He's gonna get a workout. I could use the stick, but I like the machine gun. Needs a workout every once in a while. The perforator. Like I said, we're gonna run through this awfully quick. When you're doing this at a lower level, it takes a while. But we're not a lower level anymore. Beginning, 3 of 9. Surviving, 1 of 9, so it's not RNG. Magnitude, magicians, there we go. Deactivate. There's gas in here, so be careful. Munching. Okay, we'll go up after. We'll stay down. Oh, there's one munching away there. Just about got away from me. Getting lost again, guys. Okay. What did I miss? Trying to get fancy here. We're hitting raider territory. There's some mines here. I'm surprised. Wilhelm Wharf, that's one of the spots I go, oh, I'll hit that when I need mines. Because it's usually got lots of mines. Like, at least 10. I don't know what happened there, why there was no mines this time. And here's rock salt. Come back and get his key if I remember. I gotta go to Andale and get those keys. I'm just anal that way. I like to, you know, you look at your thing and it's got all the stuff on it. Memories, you know, you break out the key ring and you go, oh yeah, I remember that. I'm just that way. Sugar bombs, nice. There's the pre-war book, nice. Can sleep in here because we killed them. I'll take that vodka. Area. I think I was going to say there should be a magazine in here, me and my magazines. And there's the rock salts thing, but he's got another one too. Oh wow, guys. I thought he had another one that you unlocked. I think it's later on. The next area, he's got a foot locker you unlock. Unfortunately, you can't turn those off. Is that beeping in my ears? I might just grab that key rather than run all the way back. Oh, I missed a mine. Look at that. Yeah, let's grab that key now. I'm pretty sure later there's a footlocker that uses that key as well as that safe. Okay, let's do this. Is there one under that mole rat? No. It's about as effective as that stick, eh? And we get finally, I'll gain 4 pounds. I can finally get rid of that stick. I can't wait, actually. A red herring. Oh, can I get a double here? Oh man, that's so close to being a double. Come on, give me a double. Double, 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 double. Oh man, that's so close. I probably won't get any because it's on very hard. He's limping though.
Get back, you monkeys. I got first call on the goods.
That wasn't very good. Getting cocky. In a hurry. In a hurry. You know what I say about that. Okay, there's a door down there, and we'll go up here and see what's up here. A metro. Okay, well, check down here first, I guess. Bottle cap mine, remember what I was saying? Every one of these has a bottle cap mine on them, at least one. Every once in a while you'll get one with a Nuka grenade on it. I don't know if those are set ones or not, but you do run across them every once in a while. Okay. So a little storage area. Looks like we're done here. Oh, I got a whole area up there, or did I? I'm missing an area. Well, let's go see where this metro comes out. Georgetown again. Talon again. We'll explore in here later.
You're dead.
I don't need to fight that right now. They're doing a good job. Let's go explore the rest of this. I think it's explored. My map is telling me it isn't. Got a little area up there. I could have sworn he had a locked chest, but I might have hit it already. He had a safe and then his own chest. Rock salt. And I'm gonna get lost. Yeah. That's that. That's Georgetown. Okay, that went pretty fast, actually. We're on our way home. Yeah, because I think that just is a dead end up here. Can't go up here. I'm just misremembering. Looking for mines along the way. I'll take another look, though. Yeah. No, that's I must have opened it. Or I'm misremembering. Because I remember him having one of these was even called Rock Salt's thing, but Foot Locker. Another red plate there. Yeah, I remember one of these even being called Rock Salt's locker, but it didn't have anything of consequence in it. Okay, I'm misremembering this then. Oh, how'd I miss that? Can't miss my loots. Okay, we're out of here. That's gonna bug me. There it is. Okay. I knew it was something. I just knew it. I knew it was something. Hey. Not crazy. Just insane, guys. Turn on the light, I guess. Anything in there? Anything under those books? Let's lift up this box. There we go, hey? Look at that. Could have missed a pre-war book. That's worth 100 caps. It's nothing to sneeze at in this game. Anything in there? Is there no magazine in here? I can't remember a magazine in this area, tell you the truth. You just came here for the mole rats. Power fist. Boy, I got like a half dozen sitting in our locker at home. It's a lot more than I remember of power fists. Okay, that's it. And that's the tepid sewers. So we'll go turn this into Moria. I'll show you how to do that little trick. Did I come back the wrong way again? Yeah, wow. Okay, I'm making this episode last longer than it has to. Should load up and sell some stuff to her as well. Get her caps. Maybe she's got some stuff I want. I went the right way, didn't I? No.
Here, thank you for everything you've done. For us, for the Wastes. We pulled together and got you this. It's the best we could do. Please take it. With our thanks.
Oh, nice. Thank you. So 21 5mm rounds. Nice. Let's repair our perforator. How's the sword? We should check that too. Perforator. How's our sword? Still pretty good, actually. I'll put away 7, I guess. Keep 25. Power fist. I don't have any apparel. Well, let's get rid of some of this. Take the vodka, Yao Gai meat, soft shell Mirelurk, Nuclelurk meat I'll keep, that's a rare item, and the Mirelurk meat. That should be more than enough to sell more. I'll probably have to come back and put some of that
it's
away.
Good to see you alive and well.
Miscellaneous. Squat some scrap. I didn't get any water though. That's gonna disappoint Greedy Guts. Greedy Guts is gonna have to go thirsty for a day. Okay, let's go turn this one in. Turn the scrap, go talk to Mora. Maybe, hopefully she's got some cherry bombs or something like that, or frag mine. Now that I don't care, I got money to burn, I can afford to pay her the ridiculous prices for frag mines.
What do you need? Well, all right. Well,
finally get to turn this in and get rid of that stick. I tested the mole rat repellent extensively.
Oh, excellent. Substantial field testing, precise reports, and such dedication. What more could I ask for in a research assistant? So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I'll bet.
You haven't heard me say this for a while, but I take the bottom answer is always the snide answer. I want crit chance. So it's like explosive whack-a-mole rat. Can I get it in bullet form for people?
It's horrible. You're horrible. Oh, this thing is horrible. Everything's horrible. Oh. With that much testing, I guess it's beyond correction. Oh, go ahead and keep it. Maybe you can find a nicer use for it, but I doubt it. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them.
She gives us 5 jet, 5 cycle. The last part of this chapter is about Mirelurks, right?
Yes, knowing more about them can help people learn to avoid or even outsmart them. So I picked up this observer device to study them in their natural habitat. I need you to hide one in one of the spawning pods in their lairs.
All right, I'll try.
That's great. I recommend the nest at the Anchorage War Memorial. I knew a trader who talked about the Mirelurks down there. Just go inside and find one of their spawning pods. Probably down near the water. Put this observer inside and get out quietly. And be sure not to kill any Mirelurks inside their nest. If you do, it could ruin the validity of the study.
I'm looking to buy let me see what you have for sale.
Sure thing.
I don't need her rounds anymore because I have more than enough. I'll buy a frag mine. See, now she only wants 30 because my barter's higher. Nothing. Just that. Okay, let's sell her some stuff. I think it's all under 8 that I got the stuff, eh? How many? 20? 20. No, it'd be like 8. Oh. Okay. Okay, what do I got? That's 6. Nothing. Everything's gonna have a high price because I got a high barter.
Good hunting.
Now. I have to go now. Yeah, my lurk meat works good, and it weighs nothing. So let's go finish off this quest. This is why I do it like this. Because you get in there, you can go and do the thing. All the little things in there, and you just have to come over here. And where's that door? There's a door right over here. And there shouldn't be anything around, actually. Taking a little bit of rads from something. There should be a door right here where I can just go in and drop this off. Sneak mode just in case. Normally you come here and they're all standing by this door, and it's hard to sneak around and you can't hurt them, right? That's the whole quest. You just come in here, leave the spot, hide the observation device. Voila, that's chapter 2 done for Mora. And the reason I do it like this is because I want to do all of Rivet City together.
Yes?
And she's got a quest eventually in the third chapter that takes you to Rivet City to find the history. So I want everything to coalesce together.
So are they intelligent?
So you just run around Rivet City.
Some sort of king
and,
or priest?
Do it all together.
Or some sort of scaly community center?
There's a whole bunch to do in Rivet City. I slipped the observer in with the eggs and they're none the wiser.
I'll bet most people would have just gone in there, guns blazing without half a thought. But not
well,
you.
I
You're
did.
You're the best research assistant ever. I've been getting a good signal, but what do you think about them from your first-hand observations of them?
Again, bottom answer. They've got a little bubbling castle and they spend all day circling it.
Really? Are you kidding me? No, really, are you? Huh? Guess I'll have to wait and see what I get from the observer. Some of these observations about their armor and camouflage gave me an idea for reinforced, neutral-colored headgear. Here, consider it thanks for not interfering with them. Oh, speaking of which, take these, so you can continue to avoid them in the future.
She'll give us some stealth, boys. This chapter done yet? I don't know how much more research I can take.
Oh, you. Of course we are. And I think I'm really capturing that snide wit of yours. So for all your snippiness, I think it'll help with the book. Still, I can put up with plenty of your little jabs, as long as the research is good. And yes, you'll still get paid. Here, nothing says loving like big boxes of ammunition, right? Now, on to the next chapter.
And 335 mm rounds, nice. I'm ready to start researching the last chapter.
The last chapter is a bit more esoteric. It's about the survival of humanity as a whole and how to rebuild society. Deep stuff, huh? We need to know how large settlements are formed, how to harness the old technology,
And I'll need you to get ancient history from a nearby library. We're in the last stretch now, so let's finish it up strong. What's first?
Using old technology sounds interesting.
It does, doesn't it? I mostly just deal with it after it's junked. But a trader gave me this Robco processor widget. He said it's worth a fortune. According to him, if it's connected to the mainframe in the Robco factory, you could have access to all the robots you'd ever want. Now that would be a great example of how to harness technology, wouldn't it?
No, I want the snide answer. I could go in and just finish this quest right now, but I want to go to Robco. And it's nice in there. It's a couple magazines. A lot of scrap, because there's a lot of robots.
Yeah, you should just be able to plug it into the mainframe at the Robco production facility. It'll give you access to the robots and terminals.
Plus, I want the perfect survival guru.
Be sure to keep an eye peeled for any other examples of how to make old technology work for you out there.
I want the survivor guru. I want that 3%. I have to go now.
The info you're bringing back is great. Looking forward to more.
And let's go home. Drop off that Mirelurk meat. It's starting to smell. Drop off that repellent stick, and we're changing hats. We got the shady hat. So we're changing hats. Pre-war hat's gone. I told you I would be gone soon. Six more stealth boys. What does that put us up to now for stealth boys? 25. Let's put away our hat. So I got two pre-war hats, and I think the shady hat repairs with the pre-war hat. So if it ever gets damaged, then that's a big if. Let's put that on now. And let's go put away this repellent stick finally, and I gained 4 pounds to carry with. Boom. Gone. Nice. Got 26. Let's take a look at our inventory. I seem heavy. I don't know why. Weapons. Deathclaw Gauntlet. Mom carrying lots of mines. And the nuclear grenades. Apparel. Shady hat. Weighs nothing. Aid. Well, I got 8 Nuka-Colas. That doesn't help. That goes up and down as we get Nuka-Colas. There's no weight in there. No weight in there. Okay, I guess I'm just 64 pounds. That's because of the Nuka-Colas. I'm going to sleep. I'm going to call that an episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, have a good one. Dolled out.